The strip's representation is based on the idea that in a world state we have objects that are somehow related to each other. That means we need to define some relations that we can use to relate the objects to each other. Relations are also known as predicates. For a given world state, a relation between several objects can either hold or not hold, that is, it is either true or false. Here are the relations defined for the dogwalker-robot domain in the PDDL syntax. The first predicate mentioned here is the adjacent predicate, which defines when two locations are next to each other. So the way this works is that we name the relation that we want to define, and then we give the parameters to this relation. In this case, they are two locations. They are denoted by variables here. You can recognize a variable in the syntax because it starts with a question mark. So this is not a specific location that we've defined, but just a variable. And this is followed by the minus symbol with the type of those variables. So what this is defining is that adjacent is a relation that is defined over two locations, L1 and L2. And again, there's a comment here that explains this more readable. Location L1 is adjacent to L2. Then we have a relation attached, which defines where a pile P is, namely at some location L. And the relation belong, which defines where the crane is, also at some other location. Note that these variables, despite having the same name, have no relation to each other. They're just used locally in this definition of this predicate. Together, these three relations define the topology of the domain. One thing that is special about these relations is that they are static. That is, once they are defined for a specific state, they will never change from state to state. If locations are adjacent, they will always be adjacent. There's no action that can change that. The other relations here are known as dynamic or fluent relations because they can change from state to state. For example, the at relation tells us where a robot is currently. It tells us at which location this robot is currently located. Then we have an occupied location, which is a unary relation. It takes only one argument and tells us whether a given location is occupied by a robot at that location. Then we have the loaded relation, which tells us whether there is a container loaded onto a robot or which container is loaded onto a robot. And unloaded is true if a robot is not loaded with a container. Then we have a holding relation which tells us which container is held by a crane, and we have an empty relation which is true if and only if the crane is not holding a container. You can see here that these relations are not independent of each other. For example, holding and empty are closely related. If the crane is empty, it cannot hold a container, and vice versa, if it is holding a container, it cannot be empty. The same goes for loaded and unloaded. And at and occupied. These two relations depend on each other. Okay, remaining relations. We have an in relation which tells us where a container is, in which pile a container is currently located. Then we have a top relation which tells us which container is at the top of a given pile. And finally, we have an on relation which tells us which container is on which other container. The second container here can also be the pallet, which is technically defined as a type of container. So these are the predicates used in the dogwalker-robot domain defined in the PDDL syntax. Now, here is a formal definition of what a state in the strip's representation actually is. So we start off with a first-order language L, and in this language we have finitely many predicate symbols. These are the symbols we've just seen how to define them in PDDL. We also have finitely many constant symbols. These are the symbols representing the individual objects in our domain. And we have no function symbols, and we haven't defined any function symbols. A state in a strip's planning domain, then, is a set of ground atoms over this language L that we've just defined. Let me go into this. By an atom, we mean a predicate with an appropriate number of objects that we have just defined in the previous slide. An atom is considered ground when all its arguments, all the objects it relates, are real objects as opposed to variables. So there must not be variables in the atoms that we're defining here. Then a state is simply a set of these ground atoms over this language L. Logically, we interpret this as a conjunction. That means each and every one of the atoms in a state holds in that state. It must be true in that state. So we can say that a ground atom P holds in a state S if and only if P is an element of this set S. So a state is a set of ground atoms, and if P is an element of that set, then we say that P holds in that state. And vice versa, if P is not an element of that set, we say that P does not hold in that state. We call that the closed world assumption. And this is quite an important assumption made by the Stripps representation, as we define it here. We can also define what it means for a state to satisfy a set of ground literals G. I need to explain this. A literal is basically an atom that is either positive or negative, so it can be an atom or a negated atom. G is our set of ground literals, and I've used the letter G here because eventually this is how we will represent goals in our planning problems. And this is simply the symbol we use to denote that S satisfies G. And we consider this the case if every positive literal in G is also in S, so every positive literal in G holds in S, and every negative literal in G does not hold in S, so it's not an element of S. Let's illustrate this with an example. Depicted here is a state in the dogwalker robot domain. I hope you all intuitively understand what's going on in this picture, but for our planner we need to translate this state into our formal representation in the Stripps representation. This means we need to define the set of ground atoms that hold in this state. We can do this by going through the relations individually or in some other order. The first relation we defined earlier is the adjacent relation, and that tells us which locations are reachable from which other locations. So we have two locations here, location 1 and location 2, and they are connected by this path. So what we have is that location 1 is adjacent to location 2 and vice versa, and that's what we've got here. We need to actually write down both ways of this relation. The symmetry of this relation is of course not known to the planner automatically. Then we have two piles, P1 and P2, and they are both at location 1. And that's what we express with these two ground atoms here, that P1 is at location 1 and P2 is also at location 1. And then we have one crane, denoted by the symbol crane 1, and again we write down that the crane 1 belongs to location 1. So this defines the topology of the domain. What we also have in this example is this robot R1, and we can see here that the robot is at location 2, which is this relation here. And that means that location 2 is occupied by this robot. And we can also see that the robot is unloaded, which means there's no container on the robot. Also, the crane isn't holding a container, so empty crane 1 must also hold in this state. Now, what remains to be described is the two stacks of containers we see here. The first stack consists of this container C1 at the bottom and C3 at the top. And we have that here, that these two containers, C1 and C3, are both in the pile P1. Then we have C3 on top of C1, you can see that here. And C1 is on top of the pallet. The top of the pile is the container C3, which defines this pile at location 1, and that is pile 1. The second pile only contains one container, C2, and that container is in the pile P2, and it is immediately on the pallet and also constitutes the top of this pile. These are all the ground atoms that hold in the state depicted here. And what this means is, according to the closed world assumption, that all the atoms that are not mentioned in the state do not hold. They are not true. For example, the ground atom at R1 location 1 does not hold because at location 1 there is not the robot R1, so this is false. It is not part of our state, it is not in that set, and the closed world assumption means it is false. So this is what a state looks like in the Stripps representation. It is a set of ground atoms.